So the one guy who ultimately has struggled a bit here looks to be Aoi. Still level 4, closing in on 5 at 7.5 minutes. Did try lane, but oh, as I say that, they're going to catch out for a big kill on the bottom lane. Slardar not going to be able to slip their way.
Oh, you've been struggling? Let's just give you a kill.
And meanwhile, Sumail doing Sumail things.
Blink dagger, trying to get to that point. Of course, same thing is going on for the Batrider.
Dubu, mid lane, deleted. And MVP, now with the Infest Bomb ready. They have only the one armlet, the other one not delivered just yet. And they actually drop just a random sentry. They're going to find Febby. This is awkward. You're going to need to leave. Get out of here, MP. He's like, oh god, where have I gone? But he will manage to get that free kill on Bulba on the way out as Aoi chasing out QL.
Febby slither too fast.
Slowly working in to try and deliver this payload, and it's onto Sumail. He walks right into the clutch, into three heroes, even with the max reactive armor, no chance. And they got that one kill, 2,000 gold lead, and they're gonna find more. PPD tracked up, Chain Frost coming through. He does get the grave up though. This could be a huge turnaround for EG with the magnetize going. Can they finish anyone up? Thorev gonna mash him down. Febby is gonna fall though as the trade. A 2-for-1. Dubu going for the TP out. He's gonna make it, and now MP's in onto the old man. Thorev as well, just banging on Aoi. They're gonna bring this wolf down unless Sumail can turn it, and it looks like he'll try. Moving on to QO, but has the chemical rage. He should be okay.
They're so aggressive, he won't be able to farm up if he gets ganked here.
They're kind of expecting this one though. The whole team's on top of Aoi. EG looking to turn this right back the other way. They do grave Aoi. MP getting caught out, but there's the Chain Frost again. Lobbed in, it somehow bounces a Bulba, then to PPD. Now MVP need to run though, because Sumail's here on cleanup duty. Slaughters two. A 2-for-1, he's looking for that third. Is he gonna find it? On the backside for Ev, tanking the magnetized, likely to go down, pops the stick. He's got the infused raindrops. Will they be enough to save him from the magic damage? No, sorry, EG. They make it a 3-for-1. How confident are you in EG trying to take a fight against the Sages? Do you think that's something that they consider doing now, or do you just look to trade and dodge?
It depends if they get a pick. Actually,
speaking of which, they do find one, and then the real action breakout mid as they get the last one, Dubu, to follow this up. So Lifestealer connecting for a kill there in the top lane with the help of the Slardar, and Infest Bomb onto the Lycan. The trade so far, only the Lich, but Sumail going deep for this. He really wants the Febby kill. He's in quite far. He's going to have to chain away, but they go into pursuit. The Alk's done revving up, and he's going to have a chance to let it go. Here comes the Infest Bomb. Oh, he crushes a bit early. It's okay, though. Had the Bloodstone Suicide, did not opt to use it there.
Yeah, he definitely should have. He just forgot. Sometimes he misclicked. Oh.
Nice catch diving here, deeper. Though. They look for PPD. They get the bash as well. Grave does come through. The kick connects onto Febby, almost killing him on the backlines. Gotta hope that tower doesn't change targets, but PPD still being pursued. Still the long range lob. There's the Alk stun. He jams it in.
The Radiant's gonna get it.
A 3,000 experience lead and some tools to deal with Sumail.
Tools to deal with him, but they also got an important kill on him when he just finished up his Bloodstone. And here to go again.
There's the crush. The turnaround comes. MP's there. They bring down Bulba. MVP getting a follow-up track. Now a Chain Frost lobbed in. 4F just looking for that crush. The Chain Frost not the best, but they do get the crush on Sumail. Still waiting for their Alchemist to arrive. And finally, the prized hero has QO joins the fray. So they're in the power play now. Sumail says, screw it.
Aggressive.
I'm a one-man wrecking crew. He runs right into the enemy squad. But MP wants to re-engage on this. And Sumail's got to be careful not to overextend. There's the stun, though. They kind of ignore him, bypass him, and look for the back lines. On to Aoi they go. They're going to bring down the Lycan with ease. And now they turn back for Fear. Fear gets silenced up. Fear gets brought down. That's another track kill. And still QO dives right past Sumail. On the PPD, butchering the back lines and landing kill after kill. QO finds himself now 3-2-3, but it could be more. They have a blink cooling down suit. They don't have the mana for a crush, though.
He wants all of them.
Wow. You said you called it, Wagas. Oh, QO gonna get caught out here. This could be a big grab on the Alchemist. As the Chemical Rage still going, but don't know if it's going to matter. He turns, he lobs out a stun.
He doesn't have AD.
He does manage to purchase the Octarine. Even if he goes down, won't lose gold, but will give up a hell of a lot to EG. He's tanky though, and MP arrives. The cavalry comes from the rear. QO's got backup. He's got track as well. There's a Haste Rune lurking in the river, but Sumail won't be allowed to get it. Fear's likely to be next. 4F just lurching forward. They bring down three. They're looking for the fourth. EG this slaughtered. Time after time, they hemorrhage the kills, and Fear, the old man who once dominated this game, it's but a blip on the radar for MVP. But MVP may also just end this game before it even gets to that point. Dubu slow sieging the bottom tower as a lich. But more importantly, it's 4F. Bam! With the two hero crush. Then the silence on the PPD. Great focus here from MVP as they'll grab two more. MP cool under pressure. And while that was happening, they also just kill the tower bottom. The sledge played so confidently.
He's not legging Aoi run either. The silence, is it there? But they don't have it. But
not even going to bother. It feels like there's just no hope for EG. Mm. GG. They call it here. One game away now from starting with Secret in the lower bracket.
I told you, man, MVP, they don't tire. They don't get exhausted. They just played a super long game, crazy stuff going down. They're like, it's fine. We'll just play one more.
I look at this top lane and I just see continuous disaster written all over it.
Yeah, charges coming in, but they're so healthy right now. How do you bring them down? Bottle charges, magic wand.
They're going to try for it though. 4F gets caught. The Sunray doing work. Feppy's got to keep his buddy alive. If he goes down, this could be the start of the comeback.
But
he jukes into the trees. Kill that little ball. Kill it. They can't. They try with the chain. It's off the mark. And now 4F going to come in. There's the swoop. But PPD also needing to get out at the same time as Aoi desperately tries to finish the job. This armadillo simply won't die. He even moves forward, just lurching in after Aoi. The goose spam continues. He doesn't have the chain in time. And this is a tri lane. Remember that. The blink dagger for MP. As three heroes converge on the top lane,
Boy, TP.
The haste rune is up on the bat as well. Boyd's got the chrono, he catches out Dubu. It's a great one from Bulba, but Febby is there, keeping 4F alive for a long time. The charge does come through though, and 4F will fall, and now the chase is on EG, looking for more. The bat comes from the rear. He's gonna drag the jump man down to the low ground. Still, it's a 2-for-1 thus far. Sumail in a lot of trouble, has stick charges, hanging onto the patiently, but Bulba's moving in. MP juking a bit up to the tree lane. Can they lock him down? There's the time walk forward. They actually lost the invoker. He roasted in the flames. Bulba getting juked as MP runs rings around him, just stacking up the napalm. It forces out another Phoenix TP top. The tri-core strat.
And it's very hard to do good smokes as well. And here goes the flame break, just perfect.
They find Sumail, but the chrono's there. It's a beauty from Bulba. Catching out three from MVP. It's up to Febby to save this. QL though has the armlet. He's tanky. They bring down PPD. Aoi on the run with MP on the chase. Can they finish off this timber? They've got the magic damage to bring him down. QL with the toggles. Oh no, EG. They gotta get out. They can't deal with that angry fish, man.
No.
The sushi wakes up and starts eating.
QL will not die.
Like, lover.
Maybe stop them from this. Nope. A dive to steal?
Is he going for it? PPD feeling desperate. He drops the egg outside the pit, but MVP can shrug it off, or they can just maybe kill him. QO, he chooses the aggression method, but PPD does get the egg off. Have they baited him in? He manages to toggle the armlet on again. Is he going to get it off and on once more? Yes, he does. QO staying alive for way too long. Finally, they will connect and find the kill, but MP had another lasso. He brings down the Spirit Breaker again. Space Cow out of the fight.
It's all on Sumail at this point. He has to bring some amazing team fights.
They have to hit the perfect combo, and they're going to move towards these Ancients. Are they risking a fight into it? That is a bold move as Aoi hunts Dubu down to the river. The chrono goes the other way. A bit of a disjointed fight from EG, but they do dump the damage onto Febby. Mech's there to keep the Io alive. Will eventually fall, and now PPD dropping the egg in the middle of an enemy squad. It's a really good fight by EG. They got to kill this egg off. They're kind of late to do so. MP doesn't get it in time. He even gets stunned by the egg. Oh. Actually, an immaculate fight by EG, but then the crush. QO again trying to save the day. He gets up another armlet toggle again in the midst of the entire enemy squad. AG, even when it's perfect, it's shit. It's just not good enough.
I don't know what to say.
Yafetz is just turning over in his grave right now.
I'm just feeling
it's just too far behind for EG. They've got the Timber Cell damage on top, and they're still losing these fights.
They're getting gripped.
There's the lasso onto Sumail. They're going to drag him back far away from the confines and safety of his home. Down he goes. They do match the counterplay. They're still killing off the Witch Doctor. But now 4F and MP are into the back lines. That's before Big Daddy slaughtered our lives, and QO's just waiting. He finds the two-hero crush. Always on target. Fear down. How are we likely to be next? Up to the high ground. Frantically back towards the well, but that's where 4F's going to hurt him. It's all immediately Fear rejoining this one. Oh, he TP's in. He's got no charge. I think they know it too. They're going deeper for Bulba. EG, it's time to leave the game. Your run's over. They call it now. It's EG and it's Secret both down to the lower bracket. The Koreans are on top. Eternal Envy called it. But I don't think he expected the story to go quite this way.
No, definitely not. And congrats to MVP going into the winner bracket, not having to go into that best of one in the lower bracket first round. Really scary stuff for EG now as they join, as you say, Secret and EG down there. What a crazy world we live in.